What's going on, ladies and gentlemen? It's me, Mikey Pipes. Today we're working on this home right here. We're in Manhasset, which is on the north shore of Long Island in Nassau County in the great state of New York. This home's got steam heat. About 15 years ago, some knuckleheads didn't know how to pipe in a steam boiler, and ever since then, they've been having problems with the steam. Let's go take a look what's going on and fix it with the Viega MegaPress. Smash that thumbs up button and subscribe. Let's go. All right, here we got Burnham. I think this is a 206. What do we have in here? Let's see. Yep, 206. 175,000 BTU gas-fired boiler. And today, not only are we gonna insulate all this, but we're gonna take out this mess and make it the right way. There is, this header is done wrong. Wrong. And we're gonna take that out and we're gonna redo it using the Viega MegaPress. All right, so I got all the fittings that we need ready, as well as this worthless, very expensive, overpriced pipe preparation tool that kills drills. Peter is using the Milwaukee M18 bandsaw. Yeah, we're going to salvage this, and we're going to take the threads off of there, and we're going to rebuild this, creating a drop header. So stick around, you're not going to want to miss. All right, so we prepared the two-inch risers coming out of the top of the steam boiler using the Milwaukee MegaPress pipe prep tool. There's one MegaPress 90, there's two. That's a lot of effing money right there, I'll tell you. So now we're going to do a street 90, pick this up with a T here, 90, pick this up, shoot across with our equalizer. I may go even up a little bit higher, maybe. Let's see what our height is. Let's see, we like to be 24 inches off the top of the boiler, and right now we're at 18 plus there. You know what? I'm really thinking about it, Peter. If we bring this up to there with two couplings, I think it would really, really, really make a world of a difference. Yep, let's do that. Two couplings. All right, so I got Peter cutting the threads off at the end of a 2-inch pipe. We're going to extend this 12 inches, and that puts me right around there. We're going to have really, 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 really dry steam. You know, if we keep it too low, that violently boiling water, which you think is just right here, when you see that water line, it's actually all the way up here. So the higher we make this, the more likely that all that boiling water is going to not reach the top. But even if it does, the purpose of the drop header is to come back down and then make its way back to the equalizer on the return side. And we take off the top, giving that nice dry steam to our steam main. It's really, really going to look nice. All right, now that Peter has cut the 12-inch piece, we're going to treat this pipe, prepare it. You all right?
Yeah. I've never actually done
this. Just shove it in there.
Shove it in there, go.
Push against it. There you go. Stop. Now, you try to get the side with the sandpaper that's on there. So we'll go like this. How about we put it there, where you have a nice even surface there, and now go around the drill with the drill, with the tool on it. You want to get all, try to get all that paint off. There you go. All the way around. All right, see, all the way around. Nice and neat, right? Let's do the other side.
All right, so that nipple has to come out of this T. So we're making some diagonal cuts across the pipe, trying to not nick the threads of the T. And hopefully with enough cuts, without disturbing the threads of the T, we'll be able to put a new male adapter in there.
Peter?
Mm-hmm.
It fucking moved!
Oh, it moved?
It moved. And you should see it. You should film this.
I look like a monkey. You should go back there and show them. They're not going to believe this.
I'll get the wide angle.
0.5 zoom out, right?
Mm-hmm. Look, hold on. There it is. Oh, yeah. Oh. Oh, here it comes. She's coming. There she is.
Wow.
Good. Cool. All right.
We need the lamp wick.
Dope. See? Looks like you had a piercing there and some ripped it out of your see that? We're live streaming, by the way, folks. So thank you so much for the 51 people and 29 thumbs up. Let me show you what we're doing here. We came up with a coupling, a 12-inch nipple, press 90, street 90, another 90, the first T to pick up, tie these two in. We're going to put a 90 here, another 90 here. We're going to put a T here with a 90 there. Pick that up. We have a problem. Houston, we may have a problem.
How many do you need?
I need 1, 2, 3, and we have to somehow get to there.
We have 3 regular and 1 street.
Oh, God. We have fudge. Oh, man. I had all these. No, it's empty. I had all these fittings here. I thought I was going to have a. Oh, there's another one right here.
That's one
of the three?
That's one of the three.
Oh, fudge. Oh, man. Because if I go down like this and have a T here, I'm going to have this there. Unless then we drop across there. And no, it's kind of dumb. All right, we'll figure it out. All right, guys. Let's go to work. How's that black pipe doing? You reamed it. Now you're sanding it down. We gotta prep the pipe. I don't see Monster doing this, by the way. Yeah, I don't see any YouTuber or any guy on social media, any plumber on social media using the rigid pipe preparation tool for the MegaPress. It must have a deal with Viega. Maybe. All right. And to... Yeah, it just totally probably killed that. Yeah. All right, we're doing one last cut. There's our 2-inch coming from the top of our Hartford loop. And we have all this piped in already. Double drop header coming across. Picking up our 2 mains. That's the way it was, and that's the way it's going to be. I guess we could have split them, but it is what it is. So now we have that there. Oh, yeah, get that guns. Get the guns money. Yeah. All right, so now we're going to prep that pipe right there. It's a little cocked, but it'll still work with the tools. All right. One of the last ones to do. This really, 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 really came out nice. This really, really came out nice. I just finished up the live stream. We had 654 views, 995 peak concurrent views, total watch time of, wow, 84 hours, 32 minutes, and 40 seconds. And a lot of chat. 4 people on average communicated by chat, and most people watched for 7 minutes and 45 seconds. And it was an hour and 20 minutes long. Thank you so much, guys. That's finished. And we're about to finish this up. We are now going to turn on the heat and get this thing fired up. Make sure we got no leaks. All right. Take a look at the steam just coming up to the header on the right side. My battery's about to die, but wow, it's incredible. That steam coming up. Using the HIK Micro B20 thermal imaging camera. And you can see there's my equalizer right there. And just starting to get hot. Look at that steam traveling slowly across it. Doesn't want to make its way back to the boiler, but slowly making its way back to the boiler on our equalizer. With our Hartford loop back there. Wow. And if you take a look at our steam piping. All right.
But see, check, look at this. So there's that. 213 degrees. And then here. There's the light fixture. Hasn't traveled that far yet. All right. All things considering, we have this boiler that was installed in 2008 and we gave her a new life. We're going to have nice dry steam coming up out of both double drop headers, coming back around, swing to pick up my steam main, and back around to my Hartford Loop and equalizer. Beautiful job. There you go. Smash that thumbs up button, guys, and subscribe. Thank you. And in case you're wondering, same house, same day, we'll get Daniel and Peter putting in for the first time in Mikey Pipes Pipe Doctor history, a Daikin ductless mini split system. This is very special. This is the R32 system, ladies and gentlemen. R32, check it out. A separate video on the Mikey Pipes channel. Thank you so much. Smash that thumbs up button. Have a great day. Be well. God bless. Stay safe.